So I use don't take this the wrong way when I want to tell somebody something not so pleasant, but I don't want them to get angry. So before I tell them, I have to use this to make it softer. For example, his clothing is really ugly today, right? Terrible fashion. I could just go up to him and say, man, your clothing is terrible today. Or I could say, don't take this the wrong way, but your fashion is a little strange today. Don't take this the wrong way. Don't get angry. Don't get me wrong, but... Yeah, don't get angry is a little direct. Don't get angry, but your fashion sucks. Don't get me wrong, but your fashion is not that good today.
Okay. Off the top of my head, there's another expression that just, you know, popped up.
What's that?
No offense, but. No offense, but. Can you explain?
No offense, but. No offense, but. No offense, but. I don't like this expression because when people say no offense, it's usually followed by something offensive. No offense, but you suck. No offense, but I hate you. No offense, but you're not as smart as you think you are. That kind of thing. When people say no offense, but, it's always followed by something offensive.
Yeah. Very similar.
Similar, but the nuance is different.
Ah, okay.
Nuance is different. Because don't take this the wrong way can be followed by something more constructive. Usually no offense, but is followed by something just offensive.
Ah, got it. Mm. All right.
Good.
Okay, any final words?
Don't take this the wrong way, but you all need to study English more.
English. 자, 오늘 표현 Don't take this the wrong way라는 표현입니다. 그렇죠? Don't take this. 이것을 받아들이다. The wrong way. 잘못 받아들이지 마. 이 표현 같은 경우는요. 내가 상대방한테 약간 좀 상대방 기분 나쁘게 들을 수도 있는 걸 지적을 할 때 Hey, don't take this the wrong way, but 한 다음에 약간 상대방한테 말할 거 있죠. 약간 기분 나쁘게 상대방이 들을 수도 있는 걸 말을 하는 거예요. 그쵸? 그러면 좀 부드럽게 말을 하는 거죠. 비슷한 표현은요. Don't get me wrong이라는 표현도 많이 나옵니다. Hey, don't get me wrong, but 한 다음에 이렇게 말을 하는 거죠. 아시겠죠? 뭐 예를 들어서 친구가 이제 옷을 입고 왔는데 아, 별론 것 같아요. 그쵸? 친구가 막 말해 Oh, what do you think about my clothing? Oh. 그러니까 제가 you know what? Don't take this the wrong way. 아니면 Don't get me wrong, but you know, it's a little bit strange. 이렇게 말할 수 있겠죠. 그쵸? 그리고 좀 비슷한 표현이 있는데요. No offense, but이라는 건데 No offense라는 표현 같은 경우는 뭐 피로가 말을 했다시피 너무 직선적인 느낌이 들어요. No offense, but 한 다음에 거기 되게 공격적인 게 들어갈 수 있거든요. No offense, but your clothes suck! 이렇게 말할 수 있잖아요. 그쵸? 그러니까 그건 너무 직선적인 것 같은 생각이 들기 때문에 여러분들 영화나 이런 데 나올 때는요. 알고 있어야 되겠지만 여러분들 실제로 대화할 때는 그냥 별로 사용하지 않았으면 좋겠어요. 저는요. 개인적으로.
No offense, dear, but those are a little out of your price range. No offense, dear, but those are a little out of your price range. No offense, dear, but those are a little out of your price range.
Don't take this the wrong way, but you're a terrible person. Don't take this the wrong way, but you're a terrible person. Don't take this the wrong way, but you're a terrible person. Don't take this the wrong way, but you're a terrible person. Don't take this the wrong way, but you're a terrible person.
Don't take this the wrong way, but your place kind of has a weird smell. Don't take this the wrong way, but your place kind of has a weird smell. Don't take this the wrong way, but your place kind of has a weird smell. Don't take this the wrong way, but your place kind of has a weird smell. Don't take this the wrong way, but your place kind of has a weird smell.
자, 이렇게 해서 오늘 Don't take this the wrong way, 그쵸? Don't get me wrong, 이런 표현을 알아봤습니다. 알겠죠? 자, 여러분들, Don't get me wrong, but you should study English hard with my book, with this book. Alright, see you guys next time. Take care, bye-bye. Don't hate me.